despite having crowned King James II of Sicily, Pope Nicholas IV was still determined to get rid of him. James II of Aragon ruled both the Crown of Aragon and Sicily. He was more interested in preserving his unstable Kingdom of Aragon and was prepared to trade Sicily to end hostilities with the Pope and with France. Pope Nicholas IV died, and 2 years would pass before a successor was finally agreed. The powerful Catalan merchant class and noble families had secured large trade concessions in Sicily. These Aragon families, they demanded that Aragon maintained some control over their interests in Sicily. Of course, the Sicilians wanted independence and freedom from foreign domination. All of them. James II of Aragon negotiated with Prince Charles of Naples, the Angevin, agreeing to renounce Aragon claim to the Sicilian throne in exchange for compensation and the removal of his excommunication by the Pope. They just needed a Pope to be elected to finalise this agreement. After 2 long years, the ineffectual Pope, Celestine V, was elected and soon resigned and was replaced by the dramatic character Pope Boniface VIII. Pope Boniface VIII proved to be an energetic interventionist who immediately fell out with everybody, notably with Philip IV of France, and was later described as ending up in hell in Dante Alighieri's Divine Comedy. The Sicilians again refused a return to Anjou rule. Frederick III was appointed by the Sicilian Parliament and crowned King of Sicily. Pope Boniface VIII was determined to see Sicily return to Angevin rule and loyal to the Holy See. He offered Aragonese leaders a range of incentives, property, influence, and high-powered marriages. James eventually agreed to forfeit the crown of Sicily to the papacy and to marry Blanche of Anjou, finally securing peace between Aragon and the Angevin kingdoms. Aragon was heavily compensated and promised Sardinia and Corsica in return. Charles of Valois renounced his claim to the throne of Aragon, and the excommunication was lifted from James. The Angevins would finally have Sicily. It looked like a great plan, but no one had asked the Sicilians or Frederick. They had other ideas. Frederick III of Sicily extended the powers of the Sicilian Parliament and was immediately excommunicated after he refused to comply with requests from the Pope. War broke out again. The Kingdom of Aragon was duty-bound to assist Angevin Naples and the Pope in reconquering Sicily. But James hesitated. The situation was very complicated. Many Aragon leaders, including Roger of Lauria, had interests in both Aragon and Sicily. He had the castle at Aci. Aragon and Sicilian crews served together in warships, and a number of Aragon troops were garrisoned in Sicily. As James finally recalled his fellow Catalans from Sicily, large numbers refused and remained loyal to Sicily and Frederick III, King of Sicily. James pleaded with Frederick to peaceably give up his crown in Sicily. Frederick absolutely refused, demanded independence, and his Sicilian forces promptly attacked Calabria. James II of Aragon agreed with Pope Boniface VIII to attack his brother and Sicily in return for money, and a papal commitment to swap it for Sardinia and Corsica. Yolanda of Aragon, sister of James II of Aragon, married Robert of Naples, Anjou. Roger of Lauria now fell out with Frederick, left Sicily, and began to serve with James's Aragonese fleet. Frederick was plotting against the Angevins in Naples, plotting with the Ghibellines of Tuscany, Lombardy, and Genoa, the House of Colonna, against the Pope. The experienced Sicilian army remained a formidable fighting force. A combined Aragon and Angevin fleet set off from Naples. It outnumbered the Sicilian fleet, and they captured Pati in the northern coast of Sicily and placed Syracuse under siege. Running out of supplies, the Aragon-Angevin force gave up the siege of Syracuse. Roger of Lauria completely defeated the Sicilian fleet at the Battle of Cape Orlando. A second Angevin army, led by Philip of Taranto, landed in Sicily but was defeated at the Battle of Falconara by Frederick III of Sicily. Philip of Taranto was taken prisoner and held until the end of the war. A force of 300 Angevin knights attacked the apparently weak fortress at Galliano Castelferrato in central Sicily, but were actually destroyed in an ambush. As the land war ground to a halt, Roger of Lauria and the allied Aragon and Angevin fleet wiped out the Sicilian navy at the Battle of Ponza in the Gulf of Gaeta. Instigated by the Pope, Prince Charles of Valois invaded Sicily but was beaten back at Carcamo and Codleone and Sciacca. Frederick wisely let the brutal conditions sap the French resolve. Charles of Valois eventually abandoned his campaign. Messina remained a critical point for supplies for both sides. Frederick desperately defended it from Angevin blockades and their scorched earth policy. Despite famine, the Messina garrison held out and the Angevin troops did finally withdraw. The French and Angevins agreed to leave Sicily as Frederick in return agreed to withdraw from the mainland. The Treaty of Caltabellotta recognised Frederick III as king of the island of Trinacria. The name Sicily was not to be used, and this would remain for the duration of his lifetime. Frederick was to marry Eleanor of Anjou, daughter of Charles II of Naples. Upon Frederick's death, the Kingdom of Sicily was to revert to the Angevins, and Frederick's children would be compensated. Frederick, on his side, returned Mezzogiorno, also known as the Kingdom of Sicily, to Charles II of Naples. Remember the confusing term of the Kingdom of the Two Sicilies in the future. And Philip, Prince of Taranto, was released from prison in Cefalù. Still, Boniface was unhappy and continued to try to get King Charles II of Naples to break the treaty. But Charles was only too anxious for peace. If you've enjoyed this video, please consider giving it a like and maybe subscribe to the channel. That way you can enjoy more of this content. Thank you. Click here for some more videos you may be interested in.